Hey everyone, my name is Curtis, and I'm one of the Canadian hosers here at Gregg Distributors. Welcome back to another episode of Gear Up with Greggs. Today, I'm going to be walking you through some of the KVC valves that we carry here at Greggs. We're going to cover basic valve terminology, after which we can get into the different types of valves in order to help you decide which ones match your needs. But before we get into all of that, did you know that valves have been around for thousands of years? Even as far back as Greek and Roman times? For example, to water crops in the past, some form of valve must have been used in order to hold and retain water in irrigation channels. From there, valves have grown and improved into what we see in every major industry today. So, now that we know a little bit more about their history, let's see what valve terminology we can learn. Starting off with the acronym WOG. You'll notice some valves will have this label, which means the valve is compatible with water, oil, and gas. The gas in this case refers to vaporized liquids like hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, and so on. This is important to know because if an incompatible valve is exposed to those elements, it can lead to a damaged valve, or in some cases, it may turn into a safety and environmental concern. Here we see an L, which stands for no lead, meaning they can be used for potable water services because no harmful lead particles can be transferred into the liquids passing through the valve. Another important thing to note about KVC valves is that all of their valves feature a blowout proof stem, which prevents the handle from popping off due to high pressures that could cause damage or injuries. When speaking about valves, you'll often hear the terms full port or reduced port. A full port valve means that when you connect a pipe or a hose to your valve, there will be no restriction of flow from the original diameter. So if the measurement of the IDs are equal, then it is a full port valve. A reduced port valve measures a smaller ID than its connection. Full port valves are more sought out because reduced port valves are more vulnerable to cavitation. Cavitation is a result of change in diameter inside the reduced port, which creates pressure drops, forming vapor bubbles. Once the pressure recovers downstream, the bubbles will begin to collapse, returning to a liquid state, and although this may sound harmless, the constant implosion of the bubbles release energy and over time will damage the structure of the valve and pipe. With the basic terminology out of the way, we can now flow into the different types of KVC valves we carry here at Gregg's. Starting with ball valves. These valves feature a hollowed out ball within the valve that is connected to a handle which is used to control the flow of the system. Ball valves are meant for quick on-off with a 90 degree turn of the handle, require little maintenance, and have a long lifespan. Let's take a closer look at this threaded ball valve. As you can see, the valve has the WOG and NL features. But what are all these other specifications? What do they mean? Well, these imprints mean the valve has been approved by different certifications. Each certification is different and has its own implications. So how do you connect your ball valves to your pipes? There are different styles of ball valves available. One of the most common styles are ball valves with NPT threads, which are simple to install. There are also the PROPRESS valves, which connect to your pipes by a crimping method. All you have to do is insert your pipe, and with the help of a crimping tool, which you can also find here at Gregg's, the crimp tightly seals the system together. Next are the solder ball valves. As you can tell by the name, the valves are soldered to the pipe to form the seal. These valves are designed to withstand temperatures ranging from negative 55 degrees Celsius up to 125 degrees Celsius. It's recommended to have a professional install this type of ball valve to ensure it is done properly and safely. There are also ball valves referred to as flanged ball valves. As you can see here, the valves are unique because their flanged ends can be bolted on quick and easy, but have to be sealed using a gasket. You will also notice there are two halves, or a body joint design. This is to allow easy valve rebuilding if need be. The line we carry at Gregg's is full port, and as you can see by the imprint on the valve, are NACE certified. This rating is very important if you plan to be dealing with corrosives. NACE, or National Association of Corrosion Engineers, certifies the valve has been tested and approved to be used with corrosive substances. If you are unsure what the certifications are specified for, be sure to ask a valve professional or our Gregg staff. Now, if you want an alternative to metal pipe systems, there's the option of hex ball valves. They function just like a regular ball valve, but are designed to connect with PEX tubing made from HDPE or high-density polyethylene polymer. Some of the reasons you may want a PEX system are: they are easier and safer to assemble, rust won't build up in the PEX tubing, PEX is much more resistant to freezing temperatures, and finally, PEX systems cost less than traditional pipelines. To install, all you need is a PEX crimp tool in order to tighten the seal between the valve and the tube. Next up, we have one of the more unique designs to KVC ball valves, which are the spring return ball valves, often referred to as the dead man's valve. This valve is designed to stop the flow in the system if the valve operator were to suddenly die or become unconscious. It is able to do this with a spring mechanism that is built into the system. This requires the user to apply constant pressure to the handle for the ball to stay open. And if that pressure were to be removed, the spring within the valve would release and force it to close. This spring return ball valve is important to have when dealing with any types of dangerous substance or any situation where you need constant attention to the system's flow. Ball valves are great for quickly stopping and releasing the flow of your system. But what if you need precise control of the flow? If that's the situation, a globe valve is what you are looking for. As you can see here, the system uses a disc which goes up and down depending on which way you turn the handle. When the system is closed, the disc sits on the bottom sealing off the flow from going forward. So unlike the ball valve, the user will have precise control of the system's pressure depending on where the disc is positioned. You will also notice a drop in pressure compared to a ball valve. Due to the 90 degree angle the flow passes through. This makes globe valves perfect for residential, commercial, and industrial use. Well, we've talked about valve ratings, ball valves, and globe valves. Hopefully you've picked up a thing or two about valve basics. Now, if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to come in or give us a call, and one of our friendly customer service staff will be happy to help out. Don't forget, you can also visit us at greggdistributors.ca. If you like this video, let us know in the comments, and if you want to see more, hit that subscribe button. Thanks for tuning in and have a great Canadian day.